हेलो।
यस सर।
ओके गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इज़ द थर्ड डे ऑफ आवर रिवीजन लेक्चर। ओके एंड इन द लास्ट टू सेशंस वी हैव लर्न्ड अबाउट द टॉपिक सर्कल एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द पेपर पैटर्न एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव गोन थ्रू मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन चिल्ड्रन। ओके एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव सॉल्व्ड वन मार्क क्वेश्चन एज वेल एज टू मार्क क्वेश्चन। ओके एंड एज वी आर टेकिंग रिविजन अगेन एंड अगेन एंड एवरी डे वी आर लर्निंग न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट न्यू थिंग्स रिलेटेड टू द टॉपिक। ओके सो टूडे ऑल्सो वी विल लर्न न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट न्यू थिंग्स रिलेटेड टू टॉपिक इन ए न्यू वे। ओके सो इट विल बी हेल्पफुल टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम योर सिलेबस। ओके सो चिल्ड्रन आई विल जस्ट शेयर द स्क्रीन। ओके सो स्टूडेंट एंड नोट डाउन सम क्वेश्चन विच आर नॉट इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक विच यू आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व टुडे। ओके सो इन द लास्ट टू सेशंस इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव गोन थ्रू द टॉपिक दैट इज सर्कल एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सर्कल एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड सम टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू द सर्कल एंड ऑल्सो द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वी आर स्टडीड द थियोरम्स थ्री थियोरम्स इन दैट चैप्टर और वी कैन से प्रॉपर्टीज विच आर वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट एज पर द व्यू ऑफ योर एग्जामिनेशन। Mostly questions will be asked on that properties. Okay. So first of all, just have a look what we have done in previous two lectures. So in previous class, we have learned definition of circle, some terms related to a circle, and the properties of the chord. Okay. So we know that what is the definition of circle. Okay, everyone know. So circle means what, children? It is the set of all points in a plane which are equidistant from a fixed point in the plane is called a circle. Okay, so we have studied a set of all the points in a plane which are equidistant from a fixed point in a plane is called a circle. Okay, after that we have gone through some terms related to the circle. Which are they? They are radius, chord, and diameter. Okay, so what is radius? Radius means what, children? Studying from the lower classes, radius, chord, diameter, all these things we are studying from the lower classes. Okay, so radius means what? The segment, any segment with joining the center and any point on the circle. Center and any point on the circle is called the radius. Okay, and if you look at this figure, you can see that segment OC of the circle. Okay. Radius means singular, and if I say radii, they are the plural. So here three radii are there. So we can see this radii. Okay. After that, we have learned chord. What is chord? Chord means what? If you take any two points on the circle, and if we join that, okay, any two points, then we get a chord. Okay. So in segment, we can see here PQ, segment PQ, and we can say AB also. AB is also a chord. Okay, they are the chords. Yes. After that, we have seen diameter. So diameter means what, children? A chord passing through the center of the circle is called the diameter. A line segment which passes through the center of the circle is called the diameter. So here you can see AB is the diameter. It passes through the center of the circle, and we know that we have studied diameter is the longest chord of the circle. Okay, and we can say that it is twice of the radius. So diameter is twice of the, and it is twice the radius, and radius is half of the diameter. Okay, So mostly it is asked in the multiple choice questions. Radius is half of diameter, or we can say diameter is twice the radius. So all these things are very much important. They are the basic concept of the topic circle. After that, the most important we have gone through, that are the postulates, or we can say theorems, or we can say properties of chord of a circle. Okay, so what are those properties and why it is so important? Okay, these properties, on the basis of that questions are asked. Okay, so these properties are very much important. Okay, so what are those properties? The properties are, first property is that it states that the perpendicular drawn from the center of a circle to a chord bisect the chord. So here OE is the perpendicular drawn to the chord AB. Okay, means what? The perpendicular drawn from the center of a circle to a chord bisect the chord. Bisect the chord means what, children? It divides the chord equally. So you can see here, segment AE is equal to segment EB. Okay, segment AE is equal to segment BE, because according to this property, it states that the perpendicular drawn from the center of a circle to a chord bisect the chord. Okay, suppose length of the chord AB is 10 centimeter, then the length of the segment AE will be 5 centimeter. Okay, and that is equal to BE. So after that, and by using this, we can apply this property in questions. We have solved some questions. For example, if it is given OE is perpendicular to the chord and length of the chord is given, we have to find the radius, that is AO. Then we can apply this property and we can solve such type of questions. Okay, so second property we have gone through, that is the segment joining the midpoint of a chord and the center of a circle is perpendicular to the chord. Okay, the segment joining the midpoint of a chord and center of a circle is perpendicular to the chord. Okay, so here also same type of questions is asked. We have to find the it may be asked find the distance of the chord from the center. Okay, so in that we can apply such type of this property and we can solve the question. Okay, so here what is given? A segment which is joining the midpoint of a chord and the center of a circle is perpendicular to the chord, means here PM is perpendicular to the chord, that we have to find. Okay, and the third property was congruent chords of a circle are equidistant from the center of circle. Congruent chords means the chords which are congruent, they are equidistant from the center of a circle. Means if here AB is congruent to CD, these are the chords, AB and CD are the chords, and if they are congruent, they are equidistant from the center of a circle. Means what, children? OP will be equal to OQ. If chords are equal, then they are equidistant from the center of a circle. Okay, so these are the properties we have learned, and you have to remember this. Okay, so after that we have learned what is circumcircle of a triangle. So what is circumcircle? Circumcircle means what? A circle that passes through all the three vertices of a triangle is called a circumcircle. Okay, all the three vertices of a triangle. So here you can say triangle, in triangle ABC, this circle is passing through all the three vertices, vertex A, B and C. So such type of it is called circumcircle. Okay, so in order to draw the circumcircle, we have to find what? Two perpendicular bisectors of any two sides of a triangle. Okay, perpendicular bisector of any two sides of a triangle, and that point of congruence is called circumcenter. Okay, so after that we have gone through the incircle. We have started learned incircle. What is incircle? Incircle means what? That touches all the three sides of a triangle is called a incircle of the triangle. Okay, a circle that touches all the three sides of a triangle is called the incircle of the triangle. So here, in order to draw incircle, we should only two angle bisectors we need. In order to draw incircle, any two angle bisector of any two sides, then we can draw the incircle, and the point of congruence is called incenter. Okay, So these are the basic concepts we should know, children. So after that we have discussed paper pattern, how the paper pattern are going to come in exam, and we have solved some questions, 1 mark questions and 2 mark questions. Okay, and in 1 mark questions we have gone through multiple choice questions. Okay, in that 4 options will be given and you have to choose the correct alternative. Okay, and after that we have solved some questions, 2 mark questions, and in that we have seen activity based questions. Okay, in activity based questions, what are almost 90% solution is given, only you have to find 10%. Okay, so 4 boxes are there, so you have to fill that 4 boxes in activity based questions, and such type of questions are mark scoring questions. Okay, so don't skip such type of questions in examination when it is come. Don't skip such questions. Okay, after that we have solved 2 mark questions, and I hope you all understood what we have solved in the previous lecture. Okay, so after that, today in this lecture we are going to attempt some 3 mark question as well as 4 mark questions. Okay, so in the paper pattern we have discussed, children. So this 3 mark questions and this 4 mark questions, they are application based. Okay, application means what? Whatever you have learned till now, that knowledge you have to apply, have to use your knowledge, your understanding, your skill, and you have to solve such type of questions. Okay, so on that application based, these questions, these are application based questions. And if you think these questions are very tough, so it is not like that. If your concepts are clear, if you are attending lectures daily, then you can easily solve such type of questions. Okay, mostly children get scared by looking at this such type of questions. So go all through all the lectures which teacher has taught you, clear your concepts. If your concepts are clear, you can solve such type of questions. Okay, you have to go step by step, and each step is important in such type of questions. For every step there are marks. Okay, so let us start with 3 mark question. So here in 3 mark questions, you have to, after reading the question, you have to write what is given in the question. Okay, after that what we have to find, or what we have to prove, because it is a 3 mark question. So for every step there are marks. So don't directly solve the question. You have to write what is given, what you have to find, or what we have to prove, then start the proof if it is asked. Okay, so let us go through this question, 3 mark question. So what is given in the figure? O is the center of the circle. In the figure, O is the center of the circle. AB is given 16 cm and CD is given 14 cm. Okay, segment OM is perpendicular to segment AB and segment ON perpendicular to segment CD. If OM is given 6 cm, then find ON. Okay, so after going through this question, if your concepts are clear, so you can easily solve such type of question, children. Okay, so what is given? O is the center of the circle given. AB, chord AB, length of the chord AB is given 16 cm. CD is given 14 cm, and also OM is perpendicular to segment AB and segment ON is perpendicular to segment CD is given. So, and OM, length of OM is given 6 cm, then we have to find ON. Okay, so how can we find such type of question? Let us see. Okay, so first of all, write down what is given in the question. Okay, what is given, children? Write down given. So children, kindly note down whatever I am writing, or you can take the screenshot. Okay, what is given? AB is given, length of chord AB. AB is given 16 centimeter. Okay. CD is given 14 centimeter. Again, length of OM. It is given 6 centimeter. And we have to find ON. Okay. So how to find such type of question, children? How to find? Already we have gone through yesterday 2 marks question. In that we have solved such type of question. Okay. So it's very easy question. Nothing to worry. Just go read the question carefully and try to understand what is given in the question. Okay. So how can we find here? See here. If we consider here triangle O, so here first of all we have to draw the construction, children. Join OA, okay. OA, join OA, okay. So OA is what? It is the radius of the circle, okay. Now it is what is given? OM is perpendicular to chord AB. It means what? It is right angle triangle, children. Okay, it is right angle triangle. If it is right angle triangle, we can find by Pythagoras theorem, we can find. Okay. Now here we will find OA. What is the length of OA, segment OA? Since it is not given, so by Pythagoras theorem we can find it. Okay. So now consider triangle. Triangle OMA. Okay. OMA. So in triangle OMA, we can see that AB is given how much? AB is given 16 centimeter. Okay. AB is given 16 centimeter. Okay. Means what? I will write here. AB is given 16 centimeter. Therefore, AM is equal to BM. Why? Why they are equal? Because we have studied the property. What is that? The perpendicular drawn from a circle, center of a circle to a chord, bisect the chord. Length of chord AB is given 16 centimeter. Therefore, AM will be half of AB. So AM is equal to BM because it bisect the chord. So AM will be equal to how much? It is 8 centimeter. AM equal to BM equal to 8 centimeter. 8 centimeter. Okay. Now we know AM. Also, we know OM. OM is given how much? OM is given 6 centimeters. So, substitute by Pythagoras theorem. What is it? Hypotenuse square OA. Side OA. Since it is opposite to the right angle, so it is hypotenuse. So, OA square is equal to AM square plus OM square. Okay, so here we have to find hypotenuse square. So OA square is equal to AM is given how much? AM is given 8 here. Just now we have 8 square plus OM is given 6. So 6 square. So 8 square is 64 and 6 square is 36. Okay. So if we add this, we will get 100. Okay. So OA square is equal to 100. So therefore OA is equal to how much? OA is equal to 10. How? Taking square on both the, what is the square root of 100? That is 100, 10. Okay. So just write note down, children. Otherwise, take a screenshot of this. After that, I will proceed further. So here OA square is equal to 10 centimeter. OA is equal to 10 centimeter. Okay. Okay. Next, move on further. Now here OA square is equal to 100, that is OA is equal to 10 centimeter. Okay, now we have got the segment, length of the segment OA. Okay, OA equal to 10 centimeter. Now here we have to find what? We have to find length of the segment ON we have to find. Okay, now again we have to do one construction. What is that? We have to join OC. Okay, OC is what, children? Again it is radius. Okay, again it is radius of the circle. And just now we have found out what is the radius OA equal to 10 centimeters. So what is the length of OC segments OC? That is also 10 centimeter. Okay, so here we will consider triangle ONC. Now in triangle ONC, here also we have to apply Pythagoras theorem. Since it is a right angle triangle, here ON is perpendicular to the chord CD. Okay, it is right angle triangle, and in right angle triangle we can apply Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so here by applying Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square, here CO, segment CO is the hypotenuse. Since it is the radius, CO square is equal to CN square plus ON square. So CO square, what is it? What, how much it is? Since it is the radius, so we got how much? 10. So 10 square is equal to CN square. CN is how much? Since CD is given how much? 14 centimeter. It is the length of the chord CD. Okay. And ON is perpendicular to the chord. On from the center of a circle to a chord, bisect the chord. The whole length of the chord is 14 centimeter. So CN is equal to DN. Okay, that is, it will be 7 centimeter. So CO square is equal to 10 square, and CN is equal to 7 square. And here we have to find ON. Okay, now ON square is equal to 10 square minus 7 square. So 10 square is how much? That is 100 minus 49. So 100 minus 49, it is how much? 100 minus 49, that is 51. Okay, ON square is equal to 50. Now taking square root on both the side, what we are going to get? ON is equal to under root 51. Okay, since it is not a perfect square, 51 is not a perfect square, so leave as it is. Okay, so what is the length of ON? ON is equal to root 51 centimeter. So this is the answer. Okay, so in this way you can find. So what we have done here, we have first took triangle OMA. First we have done the construction, we have joined OA. Okay, and we have took triangle OMA. So in that, since it is a right angle triangle, so we have applied Pythagoras theorem and we have found the length of OA. Okay, after that we have considered triangle ONC. Okay, ONC, and in that we have to find ON square. ON we have to find length of ON. Okay, so from that, by applying Pythagoras theorem, we have found that. Okay, so ON is equal to 51 centimeter, under root 51 centimeter. Please note down, otherwise take screenshot. I hope you all understood. Okay. Next, move on to the next question. So in 3 marks question, second question, we can see. So in this question. What is given? In the figure, chord AB congruent to chord CD. Now here, chord AB is congruent to chord CD is given. Okay. And chord AB is perpendicular to chord CD is given. Okay. And also M and N are the midpoints of chord AB and chord CD respectively. Prove that MONE is a square. So we have to prove that chord letter MONE is a square. So children, this type of questions you can't find in your syllabus, in your test book. It is apart from syllabus. So kindly note down whatever I am giving here. Note down in your notebook or you can take the screenshot. Okay. So first of all, write down what is given. So what is given? AB, chord AB is congruent to chord CD given. Okay. Also, what is given? This chord AB is perpendicular to chord CD. It is given. It means what? Angle AEC. Angle AEC is equal to 90 degrees. Since this chord are perpendicular to each other, therefore angle AEC is equal to 90 degrees. Okay. Again, what is given? M and N are the midpoints of chord AB and chord CD. That also you have to write down. And chord AB is perpendicular to chord CD. Okay. To prove, what you have to prove here? What you have to prove here? Chord letter MONE. N is a square, that we have to prove. So to prove, you have to write down what is chord letter M O N E is a square, that we have to prove. Okay. So in order to prove it is a square, what we have to show? We have to show adjacent sides. Here adjacent sides are equal. Why they are equal? Because these are the congruent chords, and congruent chords are equidistant from the center of a circle. It means what? MO is equal to ON. Okay. If chords are congruent, congruent chords are equidistant from the center of a circle. Okay. By the property, congruent chords are equidistant from the center of a circle. Therefore, MO is equal to ON. Okay. Adjacent sides are equal. Again, what? Here OM is perpendicular to AB given and ON is perpendicular to CD given. Means this angle OME is 90 degree right angle. Again this ONE also 90 degree. But in order to prove whether this chord letter is a square, what we have to do? We have to prove that. What we have to prove? We have to prove that if you prove these two triangles, children, if you prove these triangles are congruent, we can find that chord letter MONE is a square. Okay, you have to prove all the in square what all the sides are equal, otherwise all the angles are right angle. Okay, if you prove that, we can say that chord letter MONE is a square. Okay, so let us prove. So I will write a proof here, children. Proof. Again, we have to do your construction. What construction we have to do? We will join OE. OE, okay. OE, okay. Now, here OM is perpendicular to AB and ON is perpendicular to CD. Okay. Therefore, if they are perpendicular, then angle OMB, this angle OMB, this one, angle OMB is equal to angle OND. Why they are equal? Since OM is perpendicular to AB and ON is perpendicular. Okay. Therefore, angle, it can be written as angle OME, this angle, OME, this angle, OME is equal to
angle O and E. Why they are equal? They are 90 degree. Each 90 degree. Okay. 90 degree. Therefore, and also, just now I told you, congruent chords are equidistant from the center of a circle. Therefore, O N is equal to O N. Why? Because, just a minute, O N. Okay. Reason is because they are congruent chords. AB is congruent to chord CD. Okay. Therefore, O M is equal to O N. Okay. Congruent chords are equidistant from the center of a circle. Now, children, if we take these two triangles, triangle OME and triangle ONE, and if you prove that they are congruent, so let us prove these two triangles are congruent. So take screenshot. Okay. Now, in triangle OME and triangle ONE, ONE. Okay. If we prove these two triangles are congruent, then we can say that this quadrilateral MONE is a square. So, in triangle OME and triangle ONE, OM is equal to ON. ON, it is given. Okay. It is given. Given. Okay. Again, angle OME is equal to angle ONE. What is the reason? It is 90 degree. And third, what is third? OE is equal to OE. It is the common side. Okay. Common side to both the triangles, OE. So reason is there, it is common side. Common side. So we can say that by which congruency condition? By RHS congruency condition, we can say that these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, by RHS congruency condition, triangle OME is congruent to triangle ONE. ONE. Okay. Since we have proved that these two triangles are congruent, then their remaining parts are also same. Okay. Are in proportion. So, now here, if we prove ME is equal to NE. Okay. So, if these two triangles are congruent, means their remaining parts are also are in proportion. Okay. Therefore, segment AE, or we can say side ME, is equal to NE. What is the reason? CPCT, corresponding part of the congruent triangle. Okay. ME is equal to NE. This one. ME is equal to NE. They are corresponding part of the congruent triangle. Okay. So till now, till here, now take the screenshot, then so that I can proceed further. Okay. Since we have proved that ME is equal to NE, also MO is equal to ON. It means what? Adjacent sides are equal, and also adjacent angles are also equals. It means what? It means what? It is a square. Okay. So quadrilateral MONE is a square. So what we have done? We took here two triangles, and we have proved that they are congruent. If they are congruent, then their remaining parts are also in proportions. Okay. So from that we have shown that ME is equal to NE, since they are corresponding part of the congruent triangle, and already MO is equal to NO. They are the adjacent side. All the adjacent sides are equal, and also the adjacent angles are equal. Okay. So we can say that quadrilateral MON is N is a parallel, sorry, square. Okay, is it clear? Take screenshot. So next we will move on to the 4 mark questions. Okay, so let us see what is given in the question. In a circle of radius 13 centimeter, and such type of question is very important, they may come in the exam, such type of question. In a circle of radius 13 centimeter, PQ and RS are two parallel chords of length 24 centimeter and 10 centimeter respectively. So what is given in a circle of radius 13 centimeter? So whenever there is, if it is a diagram is not given in the question, you have to draw it. Okay, so that you will get the idea how to solve such type of question. So in a circle of radius 13 centimeter, PQ and RS are the two parallel chords of length 24 centimeter and 10 centimeter respectively. So calculate the distance between the chords if they are on the same side of the center. So here two conditions are there. So first we will see first one, on the same side of the center, if two chords are on the same side of the center. So let us solve. First of all, you have to draw the diagram. Okay, draw the circle. Yes. Okay, now first one, on the same side of the center, you have to take two chords which are on the same side of the center. Okay, so we will draw here chords. PQ and RS are two parallel chords of length 24 centimeters. So this will be, first chord will be PQ, and length of PQ is given how much? 24 centimeter. 24 centimeter. And second chord, which is parallel to the first chord, and length of that chord is RS. You will take it as RS. It is given how much? It is given 10 centimeter. RS. RS 10 centimeter. Okay. Now we have to find, what we have to find, we have to calculate the distance between the chord. We have to calculate the distance between the chord. So if we join, means what we have to find, we have to find the distance between the chord. We'll name it as center as O, and the point perpendicular to the chord RS at point A, and perpendicular to the chord PQ at point T. You will take it as T. Okay, so I will draw here diagram so it will be more easily clear. So we have to find here distance of the chord, two chords, means what you have to find, we have to find the distance TA, distance of the chord between the two chords, means we have to find the length of TA here. Okay, so for that join this OQ. Okay, join OQ, since it is the radius of the circle. Again joint OS, again it is also the radius of the circle. Okay, I will draw here again diagram, it will be more clear. See here. It is O, it is T, and it is Q. Okay, so radius of the circle, it is given how much? 13 centimeter. We will consider OT as X, and PQ, it is given how much? 12. Since the length of the chord PQ is given 24 centimeter, and this OT is perpendicular to the chord, means it bisects the chord. Therefore, length of TQ will be how much? 12 centimeter. Okay, and again, second chord, it is given how much? Now here, it will be more clear. So it is A and it is, we'll take it as S because RS. Okay. Now we can find. So if we now here, children, these two triangles we will consider and we will find the value. Okay. Means we have to find the whole length. Means we have to find OA. We have to find the length. Means so here we have to find TA. Consider triangle OQT. Triangle OQT. So here triangle OQT, this triangle OQT. Okay. In that, here since it is this one is perpendicular, it is a right angle triangle. If it is a right angle triangle, we can apply Pythagoras theorem. So we can find the value of X here. Okay. So here hypotenuse curve, which is the hypotenuse here, OQ is the hypotenuse and it is given 13 and TQ is given 12 and we have to find the value of OT, that is X. Okay, we have to catch X square. Sorry children, due to poor network connection. Sorry for the disturbance due to poor network connection. Connection is lost. Okay, once again I will draw the here figure. O, this is T, this is Q, okay, this is A and this is S. OQ is given how much? It is 13, TQ is 12 and OT we have consider X. Okay. Now here we will consider triangle OQT, triangle OQT. So here hypotenuse square, which is the hypotenuse here, OQ. So OQ hypotenuse square is, that is 13 square is equal to OT square. OT square is X and TQ square. TQ square is 12 square. Okay. That is equal to X square. X square is equal to 13 square minus 12 square. The 13 square is how much? 13 square is 169 minus 12 square, that is 144. So 169 minus 144, how much? It is 25. Okay. So X square is equal to 25. Therefore, X is equal to square root of 25, that is 5. Okay, X is equal to 5 means OT is equal to 5 centimeters. Okay, now we have found the center of the distance of the chord from the center of a circle. Okay, first triangle, if you consider triangle OQT, after that we will consider triangle OAS. Okay, please note down, children, please note down this one. OT is given, OT we got 5 centimeter. Okay. After that, we will consider triangle OAS. Triangle OAS. Again, I will draw here. Triangle OAS. Again, what is the OAS? O is what? It is the radius. Again, it is 13 centimeter. AS is how much? Since the length of the chord RS is given 10 centimeter, OA is perpendicular to the chord RS. Therefore, AS will be how much? It is 5 centimeter. Okay. So here triangle OAS, hypotenuse square. So 13 square is equal to OA square. OA is how much? We will take it as Y. OA, we will take it as Y. So Y square plus AS is phi. So phi square. Okay, therefore Y square is equal to 13 square is how much? 13 square minus phi square. Okay, 13 square is equal to 169 minus 25. Okay, so 169 minus 25, that is how much? 144. So Y square is 144. So taking square root on both the side, so Y is equal to square root of 144, that is 12. Okay, that is 12. So here we have found OA, that is OA is equal to 12. Okay, please note down, OA is equal to 12. Again we have to solve further, so please note down. Okay, have you noted down, children? Okay, let's move further. Again, I will draw a diagram clearly. This is A and this is X. Okay, so here X, this is X we took this as X and this is Y. So X, how much we have got? We have got 5 centimeter. Okay, and Y we got how much? 12 centimeter. What we have to find in the question, what was the question? We have to find calculate the distance between the chord. Distance between the chord means here chord PQ and RS, means this distance you have to find. This distance between the chord means this, okay, this distance we have to find, this one, this distance. Okay, so how to find? We have to find what? We have to find here TA. Okay, TA. I will write here TA. This one, TA. Distance of the chord. So, distance of the chord. Why? How much we have got? 12. Minus 12 minus 5. That is 7. So, what is the distance of the distance between the chord PQ, distance between the chord, that is TA, is equal to 7 centimeter. Okay, is it clear, children? Just I will draw quickly, wait 1 minute. This is O, this is A, this is S, Q, this is T, this is X we have took, and this is Y. Means we have to find this one distance, TA, this one, TA distance. Okay. So X value we have got how much? That is X value got 5 and Y value we have got 12. Okay. So whole we have taken Y. OA we have taken Y. Okay. So we have to find TA. So how we'll get? TA is equal to Y minus X, that is equal to TA is equal to 7 centimeter. So this is the answer, the distance between two chords, that is PQ and chord RS. Okay, please note down. Again we have to solve second question. Sub question second. Okay, next, on the opposite side of the center. Second one, we have to solve on the opposite side of the center. Again, we have to draw the diagram here. Draw it. Yes. Now here, chords are on the opposite side of the center. So here, we'll draw the chords. chord RS and chord PQ. Chord PQ. Okay. So join with this one. Okay. Again, we will join here. This is the center of the circle. Join this one and this. Okay. Now here, what we have to find? We have to find the distance between the chord, which are on the opposite side of the center. AB. No. Now here, if we consider the two triangles here, if we take here two triangles, that is triangle A, OS and triangle BOQ. So we will take first triangle AOS, triangle AOS. Okay. Now here, by construction, O is perpendicular to RS and OB is perpendicular. Okay. So it is a right angle triangle. Again, by Pythagoras theorem, we can find. So here, we will take OA as X and OB as Y. Okay. OBX, OAX and OBY. Now, by Pythagoras theorem, so OA square is equal to OA square plus AS square. Okay. So OA square, that is the radius, hypotenuse, it is given how much? Radius of circle given in 13 centimeters. So 13 square is equal to OA, we have took X and AS, that is 5. So that X square is equal to Again, I have to draw the figure, children. Sorry for the disturbance. RS, PQ, this is AB, and this is the center of the circle. Okay. Joint OS and OQ. Okay. Now here we will consider triangle AOS. Triangle AOS. So again by Pythagoras theorem, OS square is with the hypotenuse, means it is the radius of the circle. So directly I will write here, children, 13 square equal to OA square. OA is what we have taken it as X square and OA square. OA square, AS square. AS is how much? That is 5 square. Now X square is equal to 13 square minus 5 square. So 13 square is how much? 169 minus 25. So you'll get X equal to 144. Therefore, X square is equal to 144. Therefore, X equal to square root of 144, that is 12. 12 square is 144. So, X value we have got 12. Okay, after that we can find Y value. Okay, up to here, please note down. Okay, then we will consider another triangle and we will solve again. Note down. Now we can take triangle P, triangle RS, that is PQ, this is O, this is A, B. Okay. Now here we will consider triangle. Triangle BOQ. Triangle BOQ. Again, this OB we have took how much Y. Now here hypotenuse square. Hypotenuse is what? OQ square. OQ square is equal to BQ square plus OB square. Okay. So OQ square is how much? 13. Hypotenuse square. OB square 12. OQ BQ square is 12. And OB square we have took Y square. Now Y square is equal to 13 square minus 12 square, that is equal to 169 minus 144. That is equal to how much? 169 minus 144, that is 25. Okay, I will write here. So y square is equal to 25, therefore y is equal to 5. Okay, so x value, how much you have got? X value we got 12 and y value we got how much? That is 5. Now we have to find the distance between the chord. Distance between the chord means what? What you have to find here? We have to find the length of AB. Look at the figure, you will get. So we have to find the length of AB. So what is the length of AB? So we will take the, so AB. So X plus Y. Okay. X value we have got how much? 12. And Y, 5. So length of AB is equal to 17 centimeters. Okay. So in this, what we have to find, children, we have to find the distance between the chords on the opposite sides of the center. Okay. So here we have considered two triangles, triangle OAS and OBQ. Okay. And we have found the value. Means we have to find the distance between the two chords. Means chord PQ and chord RS. Means we have to find this, that is AB. We have to find the length of AB. So we have got how much? 17 centimeters. I hope it is clear to all children. Okay, students, anybody have any doubt? Any doubt? Anyone have any doubt? Please raise your hand. Sorry, due to poor network connection. Anyone have doubt? Yes. Ma'am, please unmute that boy. Shahakar. Yes.
सर वो जो थर्ड वाला सम आपने सिखाए थे ना,
हाँ,
तो वो वाले का ना मुझे वो लास्ट वाला पार्ट समझ नहीं आया था, हाइपोटेनस रेक्टेंगल का, हाइपोटेनस वो नहीं समझ में आया था मुझे।
थर्ड क्वेश्चन?
हाँ थर्ड।
थर्ड का फर्स्ट और सेकंड, विच क्वेश्चन? थ्री मार्क क्वेश्चन और फोर्थ मार्क क्वेश्चन, विच वन यू डिड नॉट
मार्क क्वेश्चन, थ्री मार्क क्वेश्चन।
इन दैट सेकंड क्वेश्चन यू डिड नॉट अंडरस्टूड?
यस।
और फर्स्ट वन?
Second one.
So, yes. Just a minute. I will explain it once again. Just.
Okay, sir.
This question you are talking? This question? Hello? Hello? Which question? Just I will explain, children. What is hypotenuse? What is hypotenuse theorem, children? Hypotenuse theorem is what? Hypotenuse square is equal to the sum of the square of the remaining two sides. Okay. So if we take here,